the overwhelming aim is to raise awareness worldwide of the importance of light science and technology. Now, that's a very ambitious and some could say over-ambitious objective, but it's absolutely necessary, because what we find today is that optics, photonics, light science is in almost every technology that we rely on, and yet it's very poorly understood. Every time we make a telephone call, every time we use a computer, every time we watch a flat screen monitor, we're building on decades, centuries of optical science. Now, there are two points to that. One is that we need to make sure that the public understand the need to support basic science, which is a general mission. We need to make sure that investment is continued and politicians understand that. But we also need to remind people that these technologies that are everywhere are not just for entertainment, but they can actually solve very real problems and challenges in the developed and in developing countries. The question of energy and climate change can be addressed by efficient lighting, and access to communications can open up education worldwide. Optical technologies provide solutions to all sorts of problems in healthcare, water purification, medical diagnosis. Things are inexpensive. You can make eyeglasses for less than a US dollar to improve the quality of life of people who can't read. And you can provide reading lights into homes of children who stop doing homework when the sun sets because there's no source of light. Light is such an accessible subject. Everyone sees light science everywhere, whether it's a reflection of light off the surface of water, or whether it's a mirage in the desert, whether it's blue skies or whether it's lightning, whether it's the northern lights where it's cold. You see the effect of optical science everywhere, and this is a great way to inspire children and families and parents just to look around them and to see things. So from a teaching point of view, you can immediately have a hook from the science you're teaching to the natural world. So that's important. But the other aspect for education is that we as a result of many developments, a lot of them linked with telecommunications, which have brought the cost of optical components down to the low level, it's very, very inexpensive to create high quality educational material that can be put and posted or distributed at very low cost to schools in any part of the world. I think there are three pillars of the International Year. One is the light science, one is the light technology, and the third is the impact that both of these can have on the world at large, and in particular on developing countries. Now, ICTP as a scientific, as a basic science institute, has this tremendous reputation of spreading education and scientific excellence, and acting as an interface between scientists in developed countries and students and scientists in developing countries. And it's a natural place to put an international year on the theme of light.